You're working for
Sure.
10 years. You
Yes.
have given diet plans, supplements, advice to hundreds of children in Ananya. What do you think? Does nutritional intervention work at all?
Yeah, a very good question, Madhvi, because it has been 10 plus years, I joined Ananya. And yes, when I started when I started experiencing the parents who used to follow the diet, who started using, yes, they had many queries, lot many queries, like whether the diet really works or not. But it was like something, it surprised me as well initially. But when I found after, when some of the parents who were really serious about following the diet, and when they started following the diet for their child for, say, 2 months and 3 months, so as early as some of the parents, they came back after just a month saying that the diet and the nutrition, it actually started giving the benefits. Like many of the symptoms, like hyperactivity and lack of attention, that was very much improved in their child as soon as they started following and eliminating some of the food which were completely, it was not allowed for their child. But yes, because of their determination and when they started, I found that it really worked. And nutrition plays an important part, a very important part in a special need child.
How do you know that if a child needs to follow a certain diet or the child has to eliminate certain food items from their diet? How do you know? Is there a
Yeah,
test or what do you
so
do? Yeah.
usually whenever a parent comes to us, then we give them to fill a questionnaire, and the questionnaire is a lot regarding the child's overall health. So when I say overall, though, yes, physical health is important, but the more questions which we have, which I usually ask the parent about their child, is the attention, whether the child has good attention or not, like hyperactivity kind, if the child is very hyperactive. And other than that, gut related issues. Now, gut related issues like constipation or diarrhea, or constipation followed by diarrhea and then again constipation. This is a major issue which I have observed in children with special needs, and as well as other issue being allergies, like skin allergies. Many a times they, because they, if the child is having high sugar or very highly processed food, then again that leads to yeast infection. So these kind of things are very commonly seen in children. And when I ask the parents, moreover, then the child is picky eater, bloating is there a lot, constipation, gases, and other than that, the child becomes very aggressive after having food. The child is kind of, becomes very hyperactive. And these are some of the symptoms, to name a few. Actually, there are a lot many when we ask them the questions. But these are the main major symptoms through which we know that, yes, there is something going wrong. The food is not really giving the benefit it has to give to the child. And there is something, some imbalances in nutrients. Through which, so through this questionnaire we come to know, and so accordingly we start eliminating some food and adding also. It's not only about elimination, it's also about adding extra nutrients to the child's food.
And also I remember you used to ask about sleep, how sleep is, because sleep is a very big
Yes,
indicator of
exactly. Yes,
how the food is,
yes,
helping or
very.
not helping. I
Very
remember we
true.
also used to do this, you also do this food intolerance test in some
Exactly,
labs we used to recommend. So parents,
yes.
when they would be surprised looking at the results, isn't it?
Yes. Right, very true. Because what happens, Madhvi, like I very much believe in going through the scientific procedure. One should have, even the parents, I believe in explaining the parents, because being parents, they should know. They should know exactly that what is happening in their child's body and where do they need to improve. So because of that, it is not just telling them that, okay, you include this or you exclude this, is not something which every child will go with, every parent will go with. So they need, so I also feel strongly that when I get something, some evidence kind of thing, some base, scientific base, And for that reason, I always tell them that, okay, this is the problem, and your child, because he's not sleeping properly, he has this insomnia, he gets up in the midnight and he has a lot of sweating issue, or he starts crying for no reason, because parents think that there is no reason for, you know, crying, but there is reason. There are reasons behind this also. And so when after this, I always recommend parents to go for food intolerance test. And these are the tests which really gives a very, you know, accurate result. So when they also see the result, when they have the result in their hand, where it is clearly, you know, the result says that the child is intolerant for gluten or for casein, and that report comes up with almost 85 plus number of food intolerance tests. And then, you know, that report actually makes the parent believe. And when they believe, then they start, then they get that motivation that, yes, now I will follow the dietary patterns.
And Shruti, a lot of our children are extreme picky eaters. They eat just one or two food items. And that also leads to a lot of, you know, they don't get enough nutrition for the day. For instance, some children just eat roti, just roti, no vegetables, nothing. And some children just eat dosa or just want to eat plain rice. So where is the nutrition? Where are they getting the nutrition that they need? And parents are always doing lots and lots of therapies for hours together. I feel from inside, if the child is unwell from the gut, and if the gut is bothering the child and the child is not getting the nutrition for the brain, how are they going to get results in therapy? You know, therapy is done outside. When the brain is not working the way it's supposed to work, or not, is starving for nutrition, and we are forcing the child to do 4 hours of therapy a day, I think there is some disconnect there. That's what I feel. I also see those children who are getting good nutrition also improve significantly faster than children who don't get this kind of nutritional support, I feel.
Exactly. It is like when we say you are what you eat. And then again, when we talk about gut, why we always say, you know, our gut health is important, because our gut is completely, you know, trillions of good bacteria in our gut. And then there is a nerve, vagus nerve, which actually, you know, connects our gut to our brain. So a simple example I always give to parents, that when you are having any gut-related issue, suppose if you are having a diarrhea someday, so what do you observe? Are you really in your mind? Are you like, do you focus well that day? You get irritated, you get annoyed. We also face the same problem. So it's a child, he's unable, he or she, they are unable to express themselves. And so they are unable to tell that what is happening inside them. So it is for the parents and for us to understand that how nutrient deficiency should not be there. And they play a major role. If a child is deficient in, say, B vitamins, B12, which are very much, which have a lot of function, you know, for a neurological processing of in our body. So if the child is deficient in that, if the child is deficient in vitamin D, so how will he, how do you expect the child to, you know, behave in a way you want the child to behave when his gut is only not supporting?
And we are comparing these children who are hardly eating anything, or are extreme picky eaters with so many gut issues, to children who are eating everything, who are getting full nutrition, and we expect them to behave like them. How is it even possible, you know?
It is not possible. So really, it is like, you know, that finding out that what the child is deficient in, what nutrients the child is deficient in, and then balancing those nutrients by providing them the food which are which will provide them with those nutrients. And there are like combination of food, so it's not a single food or a solo nutrient that takes care. It's a combination. The nutrients work in a coordination with each other. So that is very, that becomes very important. And of course, for the therapy also, so I say that, yes, you want good result from the therapy, take care of the child's nutrition.
I think you have to stop thinking, looking at the child, because these conditions are related to brain. They only think about brain, you know, as if only brain needs to be helped or brain needs to be fixed or whatever they think. But I think it's a whole body condition. you know, all these disorders that children have are whole body disorders, and children need to, we need to address it more holistically than just doing therapy, therapy, therapy. You know, or academics, 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 IQ, 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 you know. I think that's a very, very lopsided approach, you know. It should be more holistic, 360 degrees.
Yes, exactly. Thank you.